Hey, this is Zach with Wired Customs and welcome to my dirty garage. Today I'm going to be taking apart the 59A. See what everything looks like on the inside. So far so good. Pretty happy with what I found. And it hasn't been too much of a pain to take apart, so wish me luck.
Got the flywheel off. Man, that sucker was heavy. Hands off. Bunch of sludge to be expected. But water came out first. So hopefully everything's okay inside the block. All right, I started taking apart the mains and started pushing out some of the rods. I got all the rod bolts almost off, other than one that's in the corner. I'm going to wait until I can either pull the crank, spin it after all the rods are loose, after all the caps are off. Hopefully I can spin it and get that out of there. Right now I have 1 and 5, that's the top one, the very first one right here, 1 and 5. I have 5 out, I have the bolts out of 1, and I'm having a hard time getting the cap coming off, so we'll see how it goes today. A lot of times what I like to do is just pull with my hands and tap it, and that vibration is what you can pull it off on. So. If you look, I still have one piston left in here. This is the piston where the blown head gasket was. And I was just beating it out, and I didn't like how hard I was trying to hit it to get it to move. It hasn't moved at all.
So I spun the crank around as I was taking it apart and just avoided this one until I have a bunch of free space to get this one out, because it's a blown head gasket. It might have a lip at the top. What I want to do is hit it in, not trying to drag it over that lip. So we'll see how that goes.
Are you ready to cry? I am too.
Alright, that does it for this video. I got the block cleaned up, I got the rotating assembly out, I got all the pistons out. I still need to do the valves. That's gonna be on another episode. So please like, subscribe, share the video. Thank you for watching.